Welcome to Tech in the Car. This is the brand new VW ID.3. So you might be wondering, how does it work when you get in the car? Well, there's no need to press the start button. When you get in the car automatically detects you. Hit online mode and we're ready to go. Then all you need to do is make sure you put your foot on the brake pedal and that will start the car. And then you just put it into drive and now you're ready to go. That's simple. I do like how the pedals down here have a play and pause button. I think that's very cool. Welcome to the inside of the VW ID.3 electric car. I'm going to show you some of the technology in here, and there's a lot of technology in here, so I hope you enjoy this. Right, let's look at the main infotainment system. So this is very similar to what you get in the Golf 8. So looking at the screen here, we have telephone, radio, media, navigation, vehicle, sound, help, settings, driver assist, and then we have our overview screen, which shows you everything here. This car has wireless Android Auto and wireless CarPlay as well. And then you've got your quick settings to your vehicle and to your telephone, and as my hands move towards it, you can see that it pops up and shows you more information. And then we've got my phone settings here. You can see your efficiency and again settings, radio, media, help. So we've got these quick settings, and on this map overview here you can also see where the chargers are. It says a 50 kilowatt there, and there's another one down here, there's another one here, another one here. So which is in fact where I am. I'm right in an electric charging point right now. Let's go through the settings now. So first of all, let's have a look at telephone. Telephone works as you'd expect it to. You can press the buttons on the side, you've got your dial, you've got your messages, you've got your settings, you can go into your contacts, you can see who you called, so you have all the options to do that, so it's nice and easy to use. If we go back out of here, we go to radio media, you can see again your radio stations, your media options, Bluetooth, my media, and you can even have your favorites, so you can have quick access to them. So that's very self-explanatory. Let's go back out, let's go to navigation. Navigation, this is VW's navigation system. It gives you suggested destinations that you might have been to. It lets you search. You can search for the dealer. So I borrowed this car from Caffin's VW Eastbourne. If you're looking for a new or used VW, please pay them a visit. They're fantastic. You can see that's how I can navigate to them from here. Really easy to use. I can see my contacts if they have addresses, and I can search for destinations, last destinations, favorites. I can set those up. So the navigation system is very easy to use. I can go back to the map here. I can see my overview and I can zoom out and I can move it around. I can tap on this quick setting here and I can go to auto, night, day. If you leave it in auto, it will obviously change when it gets dark. And another thing too, you might notice here, it says range. So it will show you how far you can go on the range of the car. That's navigation. Okay, let's look at vehicle settings. If we go into vehicle, you can see the status here. It shows your current setting. So this is the charging setting. So if the car is charging, it will give you information about that. Right now it's telling me we're 71% charged. If I plug it in, it will then show you that. You saw that earlier in the video when I demonstrated the charging. If I click on locations, it will let me add current position to charging point. So this is a charging point, we're here. If I just save that as more, there we go, and now it's saved as more. If I click on the vehicle, I can see the vehicle settings. So comfort lighting, light animation, so it turns on the lights and does an animation for you. And as I was walking towards the car a bit earlier, it detected me automatically and turned on by itself, which was really cool. How long the lighting will stay on when you exit the car. This is obviously a touch screen. Switch on when approached, which is what happened to me. And then you can choose the different animations, animation one or two or off. Turn signals can be dynamic, so they will go from side to side, or classic. You can see your vehicle status, showing you your total distance covered. You can see your tire pressure. So this doesn't show you individual tire pressures, but it will show you that they're all at the right pressure and if there is a pressure loss. If I click on status, it also will show me when the next service is due, so I can see that here, and I can put the wipers into the service position so they're up so you can get access to the car. If we just go back to vehicle here, you can see here we've also got the mirrors. You can adjust the mirrors so they move together, which I think is useful. You can have it so they fold in when locking. They automatically go off in the rain. They work in reverse gear. The service position is there as well. Tires, you can set the tire pressures here. Headlights, you can adjust the headlight settings. So dynamic light assist, dynamic cornering light, so it will dim the lights when cars approach you and also turn as you go around corners. You can change what side of the road you're traveling on. So if you're traveling into Europe, you can change that as well. And then you can flip it around like that. You can see your brake information. And if we go to interior, you can then see the cockpit, which is in front of me here. And you can reset the trip information. You can change the ID light. So the ID light is a light along here, which changes when something happens. You can have it so it changes in these different scenarios. So when the navigation is announced, when there's voice control, or when there's a call. And we can adjust the interior lighting as well, whether you want it dark or bright. And this will change also. You can have it so it changes with the day. And let's go to data. So data will show me how much electricity I've used. It will show me my range, my mile, short term, long term, since charge as well. We can go into sound. Sound settings will let me adjust the range of the sound, whether it's more bassy, whether there's more mid, there's more treble. Allow me to adjust the focus, whether it's forwards or backwards, in the middle or not. And the volume of the various settings, such as radio announcements, volume control, it will allow it to adjust this if I go faster or slower. And it will also reduce the infotainment when parking and give you a goodbye sound as well. And you can adjust the navigation announcement settings as well in here. So this is all very straightforward, very simple and easy to understand so far. If we go into the general settings, we have the system settings, we have WeConnect, which will allow you to connect to the app. Let's have a look at the assistant settings now. So if I click on the assist button or this option in the menu, it's really intuitive. It's got a diagram showing you what everything is. So if we tap on this, this is the front assist emergency braking that will automatically brake the car if it thinks you're going to hit something. It will also give you the red light on the dashboard here from the ID light, which is awesome to see. And you can adjust that so it's early, late, medium, or off. It will have swerve support, and this will also detect people and cyclists in addition. If we click on the car in front, that's the adaptive cruise control, and you can choose the last distance selected. You can have your road layout preview, end of queue preview. So this is interesting. This uses the car communication system, Car2X, which can connect to traffic lights and other cars to give you real-time information. That's not active right now, and it's something which is coming, but that's a cool feature to have. If I tap on the lane here, this is a driver alert system. So if I'm feeling tired, the car will notice and it will tell me to have a break. The traffic sign is a traffic sign assistance, a dynamic road sign display, which will give you speed warnings if you want it to, and will warn you over a certain speed. And it will also show you on the dashboard as well. And if we tap on the lanes of the road of this picture in front of us, we get the lane assist, lane departure warning, which will turn the steering wheel and help you stay in lane. And that is the assistant settings. Really easy to access, really easy to get everything to, nice and easy. We have the air conditioning. So this is cool. So it will let you turn on the air conditioning at a certain time, because it's an electric car, to warm up your car. And you can set it on a timer for your departure time. So when you go to work, when you come back from work, you can set that on the car or through the WeConnect app. And then we've got stationary air conditioning with comfort functions. So you can do the automatic window heating so the windows stay heated. And you can start the stationary air conditioning when the vehicle is locked, because that means stationary air conditioning. So the car will heat itself or cool itself, no matter if you're in the car or not, it will still do it, which is awesome, which is the benefit of electric cars. Background, so this lets me adjust the backgrounds. So you can hopefully see here, if I change the backgrounds, the mood lighting on the car, which is here and here, will change. And I can change color to go purple. We can go to orange or yellow, and it will all change. So I'm obviously a sucker for blue and red, because those are the channel colors. So here we have blue and red. So that's really easy to use. And then I can adjust the brightness of it in the certain area. So let's crank it up to maximum. Here we go. Looks even cooler. So as well as individual, I can do it in moods. So we could have desire, which would give me this blue and green finish. We can have euphoria, which will turn it to red. Vitality, which will turn it to yellow, and you can see it on the cameras here. And then we've got automatic, which will change automatically. Eternity, which is greenish. Infinity, which is yellowish. So I'm a sucker for mood lighting. I love the ambient lighting. I really miss that on my car. And then we've got Android Auto, and I'm able to go into my music. I'm able to go into my settings, just like you would expect Android Auto to work. Okay, Google, how far away is Caffin's VW Eastbourne?
If you drive, Caffin's Volkswagen Eastbourne is 2.2 miles away.
So there we go, and that's where I got this car from. I borrowed it from them, so please pay them a visit. So that's Android Auto. We got the satellite view. We've got everything we could want. If I plug in my iPhone, it will bring up Apple CarPlay. And this is wireless CarPlay as well, so I can control it without having my phone plugged in, just like with Android Auto. And it works exactly the same way. I can go into my maps. This is Apple Maps. I can go out of Apple Maps. I can go into Google Maps, and I get exactly the same as I would have got from Android Auto, except for it's obviously using Apple CarPlay instead of Android Auto. So that works. Wireless is fantastic. So if we click on climate, we can go in, we can see the smart climate, we can see the classic climate, and we can see air care as well. We can turn it off as well. So that's really cool. I like the smart climate. The parking menu, this brings up the reversing camera. It's a very clear reversing camera. You can adjust the control settings, how loud it is. You can adjust the brightness and contrast. And you can see here a full back of the car angle as well. So you can see everything that's going on, who's coming and going. This is a very cool camera angle. And you can see here, you've got your sensors as well. So as options on this car, you can get it with an augmented reality head-up display. So you can actually have it giving you directions on the windscreen in effect. So you can see where you're going when you're using navigation. So there are other options available on this car and different specs. This is the first edition trim. So this is the first model which is available in the UK. But as I mentioned before, there are 8 different trims available. Lastly, if we go into mode, these are the driving modes. We have eco, comfort, sport, and individual. And we can go into that, and you can adjust them to see whether you want the chassis in comfort mode, the steering comfort mode, or sport, the drive in sport mode, for example, the light assistance, sport, eco, comfort. So you can adjust all of these, or you can just hit the buttons in front like this, and you can choose to go between them like that. You can see here we have the touch buttons, which allow you also to swipe, and you can adjust the temperature by pressing up and down on those. They're touch sensitive, and volume by doing this, swiping up and down like that. And then you have quick settings to the climate control by pressing there. And then to the side here, you have your light settings, which you saw got brighter as I got closer. You can quickly defrost the front and rear window if it's foggy, adjust the lights and the modes of lighting as well from that touch sensitive button. So that is the main infotainment system. This car has everything, really. I've got nothing bad to say about it at all. I think this is a fantastic car. I think if you're after a car that is similar to a Golf, but you want to go electric, then this is a great car to get. You can't go wrong. I think you'd agree that you'd be buying a car which has got all the benefits of the Golf, and also is good for the environment and saves you money. The only thing obviously you need to keep in mind is charging in your home and how long it will take to charge the car, from a standard wall charger, but if you leave it overnight, then you should be fine. It shouldn't be an issue at all. So I recommend this car. Check it out if you're looking for a new car. I borrowed this car from Volkswagen in Eastbourne, so please pay them a visit. They're really great. They will help you with any of your car needs. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.